वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग कैरेट्स। होप यू आर डूइंग वेल। लास्ट वीक कंप्लीटेड द चैप्टर अबाउट आवर जुडिशियल सिस्टम एंड ऑल्सो कंप्लीटेड द टास्क ऑफ एक्सरसाइज बेस्ड क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स रिलेटेड टू द चैप्टर। व्यूअरशिप फॉर द लास्ट वीडियोज गॉन डाउन। मे बी यू आर बिजी विद कंप्लीशन ऑफ अदर टास्क। दोस्त मिस द वीडियो प्लीज गो थ्रू द वीडियो वंस अगेन and complete the task assigned to you. Today let us start the chapter number 6, that is understanding our criminal justice system. So understanding criminal justice system, in this particular chapter we are going to study about what is FIR, what makes the difference between civil and criminal procedure codes. This of course introduction we have done in the previous video sessions. So if I remember, okay, so when we see someone violating the law, we can immediately think of informing the police. You might have seen either in the real life or in the movies. So when there is a violation of law, then what we will do? And definitely we there's a always possibility of informing the police, because the role played by the police in arresting persons, we often get confused and think that it is the police who decide whether a person is guilty or not. This is a very common misunderstanding. We feel that in the movies and all, we watch that police come and arrest the person, and next to proceedings, generally very rarely seen. So most of the time we conclude that it is the police who got an authority to punish, or rather to decide who is guilty. But is it real? In the actual life, what happens? Who decides who is guilty? That is not the police. It is not the police who decides who is guilty. It is the court of law decides who is guilty. Here also, many are involved in the process of deciding who is guilty. It is not the only court. Judges involved, public prosecutor is involved, evidences, witness, lot of people are involved in that. That's the reason why. So it is better we understand the entire procedure. Who decides whether a person is guilty or not? This is how is far from true. After a person is arrested, it is a court of law that decides whether the accused person is guilty or not. So it is a court of law decides, the law decides, court decides he is guilty or not. According to the Constitution, every individual charged of crime has to be given fair trial. So every individual should be given fair trial. The term fair trial is new for you. So please write down that fair trial. as a new terminology, the meaning of that in the course of study will come to know. Do you know that it means what it means to get a fair trial? Have you heard of an FIR? Or do you know who is a public prosecutor? In this chapter, we use a fictional case of theft and try to highlight the process as well as the role of different individuals in the criminal justice system. So, in a fictional case, understand how the entire procedure moves. Most cases go through a process that is similar to one discussed in a fictional case. Therefore, understanding these process as well as the role of different persons should play within the criminal justice system. So that if ever occasion should arise, you are aware of the process that should be followed. So let us go through the fictional case here. What is the fictional case? On 18/7/2006, at their apartment in Mumbai, Mrs. Shinde is getting dressed. She had been frantically searching for her gold chain over for an hour. So Mrs. Shinde, she is getting ready to go attend some function. So naturally, she is searching for her gold chain. But she is unable to trace the gold chain. So she started thinking, started talking to herself that I'm sure it was in this drawer. Where it is, it could be. So she started searching for a gold chain. Husband calls, hurry up, we are going to be late for wedding. So he says, hurry up, we have to move. Shinde says, I can't find my gold chain. It is not in the dryer. I suspect that Shanti might have been stolen. She always spend a long time in dusting my room. So it is 90% of Indian mentality, or what is the mentality? That when something is missed in the home, the first blame will go naturally land up in the maid servants who are working in the home, because that is the easiest thing can be done. The first doubt is on Shanti. Now Shanti, who is Shanti? Shanti is a maid servant in that particular house. Shanti Henbram, she is working in that house from last 3 years. So owner asks, Shanti, have you begun to steal now? And that too my gold chain. Bring your trunk. I want to search it. You have called the police, so if you have the chain, return it now. Now you see here the argument of this particular lady, you can understand. She concluded that the chain is stolen by मेड एंड चेन इज ऑलरेडी केप्ट इन हर ट्रंक. सो शी इन द लास्ट सेंटेंस यू कैन से इट्स ए थ्रेटनिंग. शी सेज वी ऑलरेडी कॉल्ड पुलिस, सो बेटर यू इफ यू हैव द चेन प्लीज रिटर्न सो दैट यू कैन अवॉइड द पनिशमेंट. बट मेड सर्वेंट सेज मैडम आई हैवन डन स्टोलन इट. शी सेज आई हैव नॉट स्टोलन द चेन. The action continues. What the action? Mr. Shinde searches Shanti's trunk and finds an envelope of rupees 10,000 it. Now, this is the first already you have started doubting. The second, to make your doubt more comfortable, when Mr. Shinde searching trunk of Shanti, he got 10,000 rupees. Now naturally second doubt, how a maid servant can save rupees 10,000. So he screams at Shanti saying that this money she got from selling the chain. So the first accusation was stealing the chain. Now they concluded that the chain was sold in the market and the money which is they received they got is the money from the chain. But naturally the poor Shanti, she got her own explanation. She says, Sahib, my brother and I have been saving this money over the last 1 year. She says, from last 1 year, not only me, my brother also helps me, giving me money, then we save the money. Why we want to save the money? We want to buy a bull when we go to our village. Madam, I am innocent. So these are the words of poor maid servant. But do you feel owner will agree? Chance is nil. So the next process continues. What is the next process? The process of police station. So Mr. Shinde has come to the police station. So now the entire action moves to the next stage, that is moving to the police station. So he says, sir, I have come to file an FIR. There has been theft in my house. My maid Shanti has stolen my wife's necklace. So instead of an assumption, but here you can conclusion only done. So sub inspector Rao, he records FIR. So please write down, the first stage is done, that is FIR. Once the FIR is done, then the police inspector along with the Mr. Shinde arrives to their home. Mr. Shinde returns with the sub-inspector Rao. Now what is the police procedure, they say? I will now write the statement of Mr. and Mrs. Shinde make about this theft. Let me seal the envelope money and take it with me as an evidence. I am arresting Shanti and taking her to the police station. So now here, if you closely observe, third action started. Third action, you can now say that is, first one is filing a complaint, then they return FIR. Now the police proceed with the action. The action one was writing of statement about the particular incident. Then whatever the money they take, because that is they feel that money is from the selling of gold chain, and the police officer arrest Shanti. She of course requests, please don't let him take me. I have not stolen this chain. This is my hard earned money. She says the 10,000 rupees, it is me and my brother. सो शांतिस ब्रदर सुशील शांतिस ब्रदर अराइज्ड एंड प्लीड्स विद एसआई राव टू रिलीज शांति. सो एसआई सेज दैट शी हैज अरेस्टेड फॉर द थेफ्ट ऑफ अ गोल्ड चेन. यू कैन गो टू द कोर्ट एंड गेट अ बेल ऑर्डर. सो नाउ द नेक्स्ट स्टेज दैट इज कॉल्ड बेल ऑर्डर. सो पुलिस कैन अरेस्ट एंड राइट एन एफ आई आर एंड कलेक्ट द विटनेस स्टेटमेंट्स डॉक्यूमेंटेशन. बट बेल ऑर्डर इट इज द वर्क ऑफ द कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ. बट पुअर सुशील सेज दैट बट वेयर विल आई गेट द मनी टू हायर अ लॉयर एंड हु विल सेंड एज द श्योरिटी फॉर हर हु विल यू हैव टेकन ऑल द सेविंग्स एंड सील्ड इट. सो हियर द एट्रॉसिटीज ऑफ द पुलिस ऑन पुअर इज कॉमन इन इंडिया. एस आई राव फोर्सफुली कीप सुशील इन द पुलिस स्टेशन फॉर 2 days. Sushil is abused and beaten by S.I. Rao and other police constables. Then they try to make him confess that he and his sister Shanti had a gang of domestic servants that have stolen the jewelry from other homes. There have been other complaints of theft of jewelry from Shinde's neighborhood. As Sushil keep repeating that he is an innocent factory worker, the police let him go after 2 days. Now you see this entire incident here. It is not a fiction, filmy event. It happens to majority of the people in India, especially economically those who are poor. And police try to fix and put a blame on those, the chance of reaction from them is less. So the same technique was done by the police here also. 2 days they punished him, they harassed him, but the result was nil. So court granted a bail to Shanti after a month. She was unable to get anyone to stand a surety for her 20,000. She therefore continued to be in jail. She was very traumatized. She was worried about what will happen during the trial. Court has given her bail order, but to get a bail order, surety is required. Rupees 20,000 deposit should be reported, which was not there. What has happened to me? I haven't done anything wrong. And yet I am behind the bars just because madam suspects me, and the money that I have been saving, will I ever get it back? So this is a common thinking. Now advocate Kamala Roy, because there is a system where it is that if a person is unable to arrange for a lawyer, then Article 22 of Indian Constitution says that every person has a fundamental right to be defended by the lawyer. So Article 39A of the Constitution places a duty of a state to provide a lawyer to any citizen who is unable to engage one due to the poverty or other disability. So even if you don't have money to pay a lawyer, the Constitution very clearly says that every person in India got a right to defend his case. So if he is unable to arrange a lawyer, then it's the duty of the government to arrange a lawyer. So accordingly, Shanti gets a lawyer, advocate Kamala Roy. Kamala Roy, she meets Shanti in the court. She argues that here my case papers, and she says, Shanti says, I have falsely accused of stealing gold chain, and they found rupees 10,000 from the trunk. That was the money which is got she got from stealing, but that the money we have saving together. The court frames a charge of theft of Mrs. Sindhya's gold chain and the possession of money 10,000 got from selling stolen property against Shanti. So the trial continues. Public prosecutor in this case, on behalf of the state, he presents Mrs. Sindhya and Mrs. Sindhya a key witness. So tell me, Mrs. Sindhya, how did the gold chain gone missing? She says, I had kept the chain in the drawer. Shanti stolen. No other outsider except Shanti goes to my room. Mrs. Sindhya searches her trunk in front of me and shocked to see 10,000 in an envelope. Shanti got this money from selling the gold chain. She is a thief. But the lawyer says that, so what you are basically saying that you did not see Shanti steal the chain. You did not recover the chain from her. Also, you say 3 years she is working for you and nothing has been stolen over the last 3 years, and you are giving rupees 1,000 salary regularly to her. So here the lawyer tried to say that it is not the money which is recovered is stolen. After the trial hearing completion, Sushil learns Inspector Sharma busted a gang of young men have been stealing jewellery from Sindhya's neighbourhood. Some of Mrs. Sindhya's son's friends are part of this gang. Mrs. Sindhya's chain has been found on them. Sushil tells Advocate Rai about this. Advocate Rai now calls Inspector Sharma as a defence witness. Inspector Sharma, can you now show and tell what have you found? So now the entire case is get a different term, because it is a Mr. Sindhya's son who stolen the chain because he was involved in a wrong company. But in this case, the entire case, you can say, understand, because of an just a complaint, a poor maid, she was suffered almost for nearly 1.5 to 2 months. That is how the court procedure, entire criminal procedure, proceeds in India. Okay, we continue tomorrow with the continuation of the topic. Thank you.